Temporal supports the use of TLS to protect confidential information sent across the network from being captured in transit. You can use a custom data converter to protect confidential information at rest. I'll demonstrate this by using a command line flag to enable the custom data converter in the order management system. I'll then process an order and use the Temporal CLI and web UI to show that payload data is encrypted. Finally, I'll run the application's Codec server and configure the CLI and web UI to use it, enabling them to show decrypted data. I'll use a local Temporal service in this demonstration, but these features work with Temporal Cloud too. In the directory containing the OMS source code, I'll run the worker with --help to display the list of available options. One of those options allows me to specify an encryption key ID. This configures the worker to use the custom data converter built into the OMS, which uses that ID to retrieve a key for encrypting the data. I'll start the worker using this option, specifying OMS demo as the encryption key ID. The API server supports the same option, so I'll use that, specifying the same encryption key ID. Finally, I'll start the OMS web application. I don't need to specify that option here since the web application never communicates with the Temporal service. I'll navigate to the web application in this browser window and open the Temporal web UI in this one. Now, I'll process a simple order. I'll choose one with a single item that's in stock, so there will be one shipment and no need for additional customer interaction. When I refresh the Temporal web UI, there are three workflow executions, as I expected. I'll open a new tab where I can play the role of courier. I'll indicate that I've picked up the shipment by clicking the Dispatch button, then finish by clicking the Deliver button. The Temporal web UI shows that all three workflow executions are now complete. I'll use the Temporal CLI to demonstrate that the payload data is encrypted. I'll run the workflow list subcommand to see a list of workflow IDs, so I can copy the one for the order and use that in a second command that displays the result returned by the order workflow. As expected, this data is encrypted. What we'll see in the Temporal web UI is also encrypted, just like it was in the output from the command I just showed. In fact, it's not only the result, all of the payload data is encrypted, which also includes the input. Since the payload data is encrypted before the worker transmits it, the Temporal service only sees, and therefore only stores, the payload data in encrypted form. That's wonderful for security, but as you just saw, it also means that I can't read the data in the CLI and web UI. Since those tools don't have access to my key, they don't have the ability to decrypt it and display the original clear text data so that I can understand what took place during workflow execution. Fortunately, Temporal's tooling provides a solution and it doesn't require exposing my key. I just run a server process known as a Codec server that will use my key to decrypt data passed to it, and then configure the CLI and web UI to pass data through the Codec server before displaying it. The OMS contains a Codec server implementation. I'll open a new tab in my terminal and run a command to start the Codec server, which listens to port 8089 by default. The value specified in the option at the end is the base URL of the Temporal web UI for which I'm enabling the Codec server. On macOS, running this command may display a dialog that asks for confirmation to open a new port. I'll click Allow here. I'll run the earlier CLI command to display the workflow execution's result, but this time I'll use an option to specify the address of the Codec server I just started. The result is now readable because the encrypted data was passed through the Codec server. I'll configure the web UI to use the Codec server. I begin by clicking the eyeglasses icon near the upper right corner. This displays a screen where I can enter details about the Codec server. The only required one is its endpoint address, which is a URL that includes its hostname and port number. After entering that, I click the Apply button. Scrolling down, it might first seem that this has no effect. However, I just need to refresh the page after making that change, at which point it's clear from the readable inputs and results section that the web UI is now using the Codec server.